to a social media post and you go from there.
Yep.
Thank you.
capturing some of our favorite memories of the year. This year, we've got to experience the highs and lows, the joys and the heartbreaks, the thrill and the disappointment that athletic endeavor has to offer. It is always inspiring for us to watch the surge athletes in action, be it on the court, field, or pitch. And it is a great privilege for us to be able to support you in all your efforts. Now for the stuff you all showed up for, awards and recognition. We will start with our team awards, which were selected by your coaches. I would ask that coaches come to the center of the stage when called up. Once you have received your award, please exit to the right and to the backdrop where your photo will be taken.
So we like to kick things off with badminton team awards. So we'd now like to call up our assistant coach, Abby Menon, to hand out our badminton team awards. Season was a full season with competitions taking place all the way up to Sudbury. The team made up of 3 to 4 core players bonded quickly and well to boast impressive competition against all adversaries. The whole team played well at invitationals with multiple podium finishes in doubles and singles action. During the East Regionals play, the men's team finished 3rd as a team and earned a spot to compete for the whole team at OCAA Championships. OCAAs was a long 2 days with lots of competition. The men's double squad fought hard against Humber, Seneca, Centennial, and Cambrian, ultimately earning a 4th place finish in Ontario. Our coaches Eric and Abby would like to say huge congratulations to all and look forward to next season. So for the MVP awards, either of these players could have won MVP, but together as our men's doubles team, they made each other better. Work ethic, commitment, sportsmanship, always striving to improve themselves, pushing each other to make themselves better makes them both the recipients of this award. Every coach always says if they had a team full of a certain player, they would always be competitive. We were lucky enough to have 2 of them. Congratulations to this year's co-MVP award winners, Afsar Chowdhury and Brandon Watkins. In Kingston, being a Cornwall student, showing commitment and dedication to his sport, was competitive, friendly to all, and exemplified all team values. Playing in both doubles and singles action against many schools and many competitors, this player held their own, earning a podium finish in singles action at East Regionals. The team this year wouldn't have been the same without them. Congratulations to this year's Coaches Recognition Award winner, Nadeem Nahad.
Developed and improved throughout the season, being a top 5 team in the province in every statistical category, including field goal percentage, steals, turnovers, and points per possession. The team learned how to battle through adversity and finished the season on a high note with a quality win at Centennial. They have laid down the foundation, and with this continued offensive growth, coaches are very excited to build on this momentum for the 2023-24 season. So, Rookie of the Year. The coaches agreed this athlete has shown tons of potential in his rookie year. This individual has shown improvement throughout the season, becoming a starter in the second half of the year, and began to really develop as a playmaker. He even averaged 14 points per game in January. We would like to award this year's Men's Basketball Rookie of the Year to Andrew Diedrich.
Thank you.
Most Improved Player. With dedication and hard work, this player showed major improvements over the year, defensively and offensively. He was sixth in the province in field goal percentage and led the team in scoring the second half of the season as the sixth man. He put up an impressive average of 11 points in only 18 minutes per game. This year's Men's Basketball Most Improved Player Award goes to Abdullah Seif. Charges, hustle, bloody noses, cuts, bruises, and all the intangibles you don't see on the score sheet that the coaches love. Off the court, he shows his leadership in the community with a smile by supporting local youth basketball clinics. This year, coaches chose the recipient of the Men's Basketball Coaches Recognition Award as Braden Cordero.
Congratulations to our men's basketball team. Up next, women's basketball. Unfortunately, our women's basketball coach couldn't be here this evening, so we'd like to call up Kevin Biggs to help present the awards.
Yeah, Kevin.
Our women's basketball team had an amazing 2022-2023 season. They finished the regular season middle of the pack with a winning record and close games against tough teams. The team showed teamwork and hard work all year. Despite a tough loss against Conestoga to end the season, the team played strong and have a hopeful 2023-2024 season. Defensive Player of the Year. This player's endless hustle and work allowed her to shut down other teams' top players. She was able to use her athleticism to get steals and rebounds to create offense for the team. This year's Women Basketball Defensive Player of the Year Award goes to Georgia DeGruy. She showed potential from the first practice and continued to improve throughout the season. As her confidence grew, her scoring ability and natural leadership took over, earning fifth in the league for points per game and free throw percentage. Not only is this player being awarded Surge Basketball Rookie of the Year, but also OCAA Rookie of the Year. This award goes to Ella Duell. In addition to that, she was second in the league in steals and creating many scoring opportunities for herself and the team off of these steals. Without further ado, we would like to name Melissa Gilligan as the Women's Basketball Player of the Year.
Legendary course in Thunder Bay. The season where the only legend you would know about is Catherine Irwin, who placed second in OCAAs and went on to compete at Nationals. Fueled by passion and determination, individual runners from different campuses bonded into a strong team which provided a platform of support and strength which enabled the athletes to excel. The coaches would like to thank you for all your hard work and can't wait to see what next season brings. Rookie of the Year. This runner's commitment and dedication paid off this year as she was consistently improving throughout the season. If it isn't running to make practice with scrubs on, it's defying expectations at invitationals. Don't underestimate her need to get better every time she laces up. Congratulations to this year's Rookie of the Year, Rebecca Greer. Communicative, and every other good descriptive word in the book, you take this runner on every team. He helps solidify the bond between runners from all three campuses, which created the family atmosphere at races. Congratulations to this year's Coaches Recognition Award, Cameron Hearing. Lower than second place provincially and giving it her all at nationals. Please join me in congratulating the most valuable runner of the Surge cross country team, Catherine Irwin.
Next, women's rugby. We would now like to invite our women's rugby head coach, Kate Pasek, for the presentation of the Women's Rugby Team Award.
Go, Katie!
With 60% of the team being comprised of rookies, the Surge women's rugby team showed up hard for every game. The team started the season strong with an impressive first tournament, then were then able to fight their way into the OCAA Championship Tournament, winning the Consolation Final. The coaches are looking forward to a hopeful 2023 season. Rookie of the Year. Despite it being her rookie year, this athlete showed her power to the league early on. Coaches say she has incredible running lines and dominated her opponents. She brought confidence to the team on attack as an experienced rookie. This year's Women's Rugby Rookie of the Year goes to Megan McCoy. Not only is she a humble captain, she is second in team scoring and solid on defense. The second player is dominant on offense and defense. She's a dangerous scoring threat with 67 points this season, and she shut down many of our opposition scoring opportunities. Both captains were named OCAA All-Stars, showed excellent in the classroom, and were big difference makers on the field. This year's Women Rugby Co-MVPs are Ella Van Howe and Caitlin Navone.
Not as strong as was last year's gold medal finish, the team ended the regular season tied for second. After winning the third quarterfinal game, they played a hard-fought semifinal match where injuries finally caught up with them from a long year. Coach Dennis says he's very proud of how hard this group of young men worked all year, as they have set a great example for future years. Coach's Recognition Award. Not only was this player the team's leading scorer and an OCAA All-Star, he was also a leader. He was a leader on the field with his foot, his pass, and his voice. This year's Men's Rugby Coaches Recognition Award goes to Sam Meidel. Defensive Player of the Year. His efforts game in, game out, rewarded him with being an OCAA Men's Rugby League All-Star. This player led the defense every game with his line speed and quick resets. This year's Men's Rugby Defensive Player of the Year goes to Zach Raymond. Sportsmanship, heart, and love for the game. This player is well respected by all his teammates and coaches. This player embodies sportsmanship and was always working hard to get better. This year's Travis Sage Memorial Award goes to Brandon Morris. MVP was one of the hardest working players on the pitch. He was as much of a captain off the field as he was on the field. He led by example through his dedication and work ethic. He really knew how to get the team to focus or to pump them up. He was also one of the team leaders in points, yards carried, and tackles. This year's Men's Rugby MVP award goes to Evan Simpson.
Next, we'll move on to the Golf Awards. At this time, we'd like to call up our golf coach, Brendan Smith. The golf program came into the 2022 campaign with a new coaching staff and some fresh faces on the roster. At Provincials hosted by Niagara College, the men's team put on a strong performance, finishing fifth overall, which earned them the chance to compete at the national championship hosted by Durham College. The women's team, comprised of Ashley Clark and Shannon Godden, captured bronze medals after putting out strong performances each day at the Provincials. A highlight of the season came from Jeremy Allen as he posted a hole-in-one during competition at the Niagara Invitational. Congratulations to the golf team on a great season. Coach's Recognition. In her second year with the team, this golfer had a tremendous year. At the St. Clair Invitational, she posted her personal best round. At Provincials, she captured ninth individually, earning her spot at the National Championship. Congratulations to this year's Coaches Recognition Award recipient, Ashley Clark. Rookie of the Year. In his first year with the team, this rookie demonstrated consistency all season long. His accomplishments on the course were some of the best on the team. The coaches are excited to see where this golfer's game can progress to next year. Congratulations to this year's Rookie of the Year, Dylan McLeod. Team's number one spot in every tournament this year. He naturally took on the role of team captain, leading by example and assisting coaches with keeping teammates accountable. His share of the low round of provincial championships played a huge role in punching the team's ticket to the national championship. Congratulations to this year's golf MVP, Bryson McCulloch.
Congratulations, golf. Finally, we will move on to our women's soccer. We would like to now call up Leanna Ouellette to present
my coach of the year.
Dedication to one another, commitment to training, and most of all, fun. This team culture complemented well on the field, and the team was able to push the rebuild into fast forward. The team finished with a 3-6-1 record, earning them 7th spot in the division, and the opportunity to travel to face Mohawk in the crossover game, where their season ultimately came to an end with a tough 2-1 loss. The team looks to continue building upon their success moving into next season. Defensive player of the year. Don't let her size fool you. With her speed, she closed quickly on some of the leading scorers in the OCAA, preventing scoring opportunities time and time again. Her physical presence was felt by the opponent as she consistently battled to win balls both on the ground and in the air. Her defensive play remained consistent and exceptional throughout the season, and her contribution played an important role in inspiring her teammates. This year's Women's Soccer Defensive Player of the Year goes to Michaela Penny. Coach's Recognition Award. Simply put, this player quickly demonstrated that she could get things done. Whether it was communicating last-minute coaching requests to teammates, picking up and transporting training equipment, or laying out uniforms for her teammates before they arrived, this player developed a reputation that she was responsible, reliable, and dependable. She recognized the importance of team camaraderie, and she worked hard throughout the season to ensure the team became a close unit. This year's Coach's Recognition Award goes to Sam McDonald. In her first year, she was asked to play a new position. She welcomed the challenge and consistently attended training sessions and worked hard to learn a new role and responsibility as a defender. Although she has a quiet demeanor about her, on the pitch she was fierce and determined to win each challenge. Her positive, respectful interaction with her teammates and her coaches, her commitment to development, and her consistent outstanding play has earned her the Rookie of the Year award. So congratulations to the Women's Soccer Rookie of the Year, Mette Obrega.
Record, which earned them second place in the East and home field advantage heading into playoffs. In crossovers, the team defeated Lambton, earned them a spot at the provincial championships hosted by Humber College. The team faced a tough draw in the quarterfinals, where they ultimately lost a morning matchup against a very strong Fanshawe team. Congratulations to the men's outdoor soccer team on their exciting championship run this season. Coach's recognition. This player has been the backbone for the men's soccer team for the last three seasons, always coming up big when needed, and being a supportive member of the team. He came back this season after sustaining a substantial injury last year. He came back stronger than ever and had a great season this year. This year's coach's recognition goes to Braden Martin. Defensive Player of the Year. This player was a warrior all season for the men's soccer team. His defensive performance was a huge part of the team's success this year. At right back, he was relentless when it came to closing on strikers and denying the opposition of scoring opportunities. He was a huge part of the team's back line. Congratulations to Men's Soccer Defensive Player of the Year, Johnny McDonald. And completely crushed all of them. An offensive machine, this player's ability to move around defenders is unmatched. He not only led the team in scoring, but his 12 goals in 9 games was enough to give him the East Conference scoring title. This year's Men's Soccer MVP award goes to Jacob Ball.
The hours and time and energy you, our coaches, dedicate to our athletes. With your expertise and commitment, you contribute so much to the student-athlete experience here at St. Lawrence College. You sacrifice your evenings and weekends to help shape our students into the best athletes they can be. We want you to know that it does not go unnoticed. We admire your passion for your sport and your dedication to your students. Sincerely, we thank you for all that you do. Gifts. We will be calling coaches up by sport. Please make your way to the stage to receive your gift. From badminton, Abby Menon, and East coaches, East Division Coach of the Year, Eric Patterson. From women's soccer, Leanna Ula and Chelsea Kager.
Mackenzie Sigurdsson and Catherine Lemoyne. From men's basketball, Brock MacArthur, Tom Withy, Brad Richards, and Kevin Schmidt. From cross country, Ryan Van Dill, Sarah Crawford, and Darren Mancini.
And Matt Horton. For women's rugby, Jocelyn Poirier, Steve Mueller, Michelle Harper, Evelyn LeBlanc, and Kate Passett. And for women's rugby, Travis Lilinski, Justin Dory, Dustin Hartland, Charlie Tromley, Dennis Asseltine, and Bill McMahon.
year, we lost a member of our search family. Wild Bill was an assistant coach with our men's rugby program. He passed away unexpectedly this holiday break. Dennis, I'm sure you can attest that it's not an easy task to lead a group of 30 college-age men, men's rugby student-athletes. But despite this age gap, Bill made it look easy to be at one with the boys. He truly cared about his players and made a profound impact on hundreds of St. Lawrence College men's rugby student-athletes and to kids in the Kingston Panthers Rugby Club. I know that being a coach, the men's rugby program meant a lot to Bill. But to see his 2021 OCR gold medal directly beside his urn, it was hard not to have an emotional reaction to that. I spoke earlier about the meaning behind Surge Together, and that came through Bill's visitation. I went expecting to see a strong showing from the men's rugby program, to which there was. But what made me so proud that day was to see members from the women's rugby team and the soccer teams come to pay their respects. That's what Surge Together is all about. We are forever grateful to have Bill, to have had Bill with us, and we will always remember him. Please join me in a moment of silence. Thank you.
Thank you again to all our coaches.
We'd now like to invite Chris Henderson to the stage to help us show appreciation to our placement students. First, a quick acknowledgement for our SLC athletic therapist, Chris. He definitely stepped up to the plate this year and really knew how to put a smile on everyone's faces. Another big thank you to our athletic therapy and strength and conditioning students. Thank you for the work you've done in keeping our athletes healthy and ready to compete. Can we please have these placement students come up to receive a small token of thanks?
Thank you. butterfly will hold you on social media.
I was so on.
All right, now we would like to honor our graduating athletes. While we know how hard you have all worked throughout the season and your 4 years at St. Lawrence, for some of you, your time at the college has come to an end. We would now like to call up Terry Spence, Manager of Student Services Operations, to help present our next award. Oh, is she the...
Evan, you do it.
Music?
Nope. We need Terry.
Let me try Kahoot.
Also in the washroom. Let's play some music.
You thought I was a social media guy, huh? Take a moment to celebrate yourself, man.
We would like to first offer a special recognition to an athlete this year who has spent all 5 years of their eligibility in the SLC uniform as a Viking and then part of the Surge. Can we please have Evan Sim-Spence and Lee Spence.
Please stand and be recognized by making your way to the stage to receive a small gift. Please hold your applause until the very end. So can we have graduating athletes from cross country and golf, please?
If you apply to graduate.
If you apply to graduate. Come on up, cross country and golf.
You guys do not have to keep it. You mind?
Men's rugby and women's soccer.
Students have been honored by the OCAA in various ways. When your name is called, please just stand up to be recognized. The majority of these athletes have already received their recognition certificates from the OCAA Championship Banquet. And if you haven't, you can come see me in my office at some point next week. From cross country, OCAA All-Ontario First Team All-Star and Provincial Silver Medalist, Catherine Irwin. East Division First Team All-Star, Melissa Gilligan. Men's Soccer, OCAA East Division All-Star, East Division Scoring Champion, and East Division Rookie of the Year, Jacob Ball.
From Women's Rugby, OCAA League All-Stars, Ella Van Howe and Caitlin DeVall. OCAA League All-Stars, Sam Mindell, Zach Raymond, and Evan Simspack. From women's basketball, OCAA First Team East Division All-Star, Melissa Gilligan. OCAA First Team East Division All-Star, OCAA All-Rookie Team, East Division Rookie of the Year, and OCAA Women's Basketball Rookie of the Year.
We would like to recognize the outstanding success of our athletes have had in maintaining at least a 3.5 GPA while participating in varsity athletics. Please note, these honored tonight represent the fall semester award recipients. Winter semester recipients are awarded after the winter semester is completed. When you hear your name, please make your way to the stage to be recognized. Please try to stay in alphabetical order as much as possible. Jacob Ball.
Jack.
Mohamed Bearcat. Hannah Bassett.
Woo!
Ben Valley. Nathaniel Ben. Emma Bothwell. Excelled in the classroom, receiving a GPA of over 3.5 this year. When you hear your name, please make your way back to the stage for your certificate. Jacob Ball, men's soccer, Ella Duell, women's basketball, and Catherine Irwin, cross country.
Kahoot, so
like. Next year.
Okay, so change of plans. No Kahoot, there's no internet, but we're gonna do two prizes, draws, yes. Sorry, we got the name in English. Alright, so I hope everyone still has their little red ticket, because there are still two pairs of beats. So the winner is
and all three are equally deserving of this honor. This year's Fair Play Award winners are all three nominees, Brett Holmberg, Fiona
coach for a women's basketball team. In addition, Barry was a strong advocate and supporter of athletics on the Kingston campus and did everything he could to promote the department. The Barry Ellerbeck Award criteria is as follows. This award recognizes one student athlete for their outstanding work ethic, dedication, and contribution through volunteering to develop and promote sport. This student works hard to assist the athletic department in its initiatives while maintaining good academic standing and having a positive presence in the community. This year's nominees are Brett Holmberg, Jasenia Alvarez, Brandon Cordero, Ella Duell, Lily Graham, and Hank Perrin. So this year's recipient embodies the true qualities that represent an amazing student athlete. This individual is not only dedicated to their sport here at SLC, but also the community. On the field, they are a role model for their teammates through personal improvement and commitment. Off the pitch, this person is very busy. Not only are they consistently a strong student, but also come cheer on the other SLC varsity teams and has a strong presence in the community. This person is a volunteer coach at the high school and city level. They were even recognized for their contributions in 2022 by winning Kingston Panthers Coach of the Year. Furthermore, this athlete is currently the Kingston Panthers Build Belonging Project representative, where they help promote inclusion, diversity, equity, and accessibility, leading a community-driven change project. So without further ado, the 2022-23 Barry Ellerbeck Memorial Award goes to Jasenia Alvarez.
To assist with this year's presentations. This award recognizes two student athletes who excel in their sport while demonstrating a high level of skill, coachability, and fair play. This year's winners have celebrated superior athletic achievements while maintaining a good academic standing while having a positive presence in the community. This year's nominees are Melissa Gilligan, Catherine Irwin, Ella Van Howe, Jacob Ball, Bryce McCulloch, and Brandon Watkins. Our first recipient had an outstanding season in his sport. His achievements this year include East Conference Scoring Champion, East Rookie of the Year, East First Team All-Star, recognition as a CCAA All-Canadian, and was an MVP of this year's St. Lawrence Surge Men's Soccer Team. Our second recipient was a dual sport athlete and was a force on both the court and the pitch. I would like to quote one of her coaches by starting off saying she is ridiculously good at her sport. In the fall rugby season, she scored 67 points with minimal field time and earned herself an OCAA League All-Star recognition. On the rugby pitch and basketball court, she's respected by teammates and coaches. She's a hard worker and a difference maker on both teams. Outside of sport, she serves the community as a military reservist and works just as hard in the achieving and maintaining a 3.5 GPA in nursing. Please join me in congratulating this year's Athletes of the Year, Jacob Ball and Ella Van.
For the presentation of this award. This award recognizes the true essence of the student athlete by honoring two athletes who have maintained a high academic standing amongst their peers, while also making a significant contribution to their team and having a positive presence in the community. As always, SLC prides itself on its strong academic achievements across the board. We have one of the highest number of OCAA All-Academic Awards achieved by our athletes, and we have a significantly smaller athlete population. This year's nominees are Catherine Irwin, Ella Van Hal, Ella Duell, Sam McDonald, Mohammed Barakat, Afsar Chowdhury, Logan Devoturi, Nadine Nahaz. The first athlete was one of the hardest working players on and off the pitch. His efforts in the classroom landed him with an impressive 3.9 average, and his efforts in practice and dedication while he played a pivotal position were always done with a positive attitude. The second athlete not only had a GPA of 3.96, but she also excelled at every competition this season. Her efforts won her OCAA All-Ontario First Team medaling silver at OCAA Championships and competed in Nationals in Medicine Hat, Alberta. We are pleased to award this year's Academic Athletes of the Year, Logan Duvotier and Kyle Lowe.
So smoothly. First, thank you to our executives and VIPs for taking time on your busy days to constantly support athletics and to be able to celebrate with us tonight. Thank you to the gym staff and everyone who's been involved in the planning and implementation over the past several months. Your efforts do not go unnoticed. Thank you to our colleagues in the athletics team, Brandon, Adam, Erica, and Kevin. This truly is a team effort, so we are definitely grateful for your help in bringing this all together. We lean on each other so much throughout the year and couldn't have done it without you guys. Lastly, thank you to you, the athletes. Without your dedication, commitment, and effort, SLC just wouldn't be the same. On your way out this evening, please remember to grab your surge pin and wear them proudly. Those traveling back to Brockville and Cornwall tonight, the bus will be leaving in probably about 15 minutes from the same place it dropped you off. Enjoy the rest of the night, be safe, and be sure to find a safe ride home. Thank you.
Good job, guys.
And thanks for watching. Deuces.